Dear professors, I welcome you all for this demonstration video on the new hardware and software combined interactive teaching and learning setup that I developed teaching the different subjects, not only in engineering but also on other disciplines also. I am Dr. Senthil Kumar. This video will play for about 10 minutes only. Here in this, I will explain you about how effectively what we can use this 50-inch interactive digital display. That is the hardware that I used in teaching learning process, mainly for teaching. And I'll demonstrate to you how best we can make use of the desktop annotations and how we can teach the different subjects like engineering graphics, mathematics, engineering physics, engineering chemistry, fundamentals of computing, so on and so forth. Then in the next part, I'll show you how best we can make use of the PPTs with the help of this hardware. You will be witnessing some CAD model demonstration, different images demonstration, different animated things demonstration, sample software applications that we developed for the subject engineering graphics. Now, so this is the first one we'll see. I'll start doing annotation. So this is over now. I used a 50-inch interactive digital display hardware for demonstrating about teaching the subjects. Actually, in the market, 50-inch is the starting model actually. So the bigger models are 65-inch, 75-inch, it goes up to 90-inch actually. But I'm sure this 50-inch display is sufficient enough to cover a student batch of 60 students actually. Now, so what you are witnessing now is the desktop annotations. So you can scribble something, you can write something. So these things you can do by just using your finger or a special pen you can use actually. I'll clear all these annotations, right? So these are the things we have seen actually, right? Now we'll see about how best we can use this particular hardware and the software we developed exclusively for this engineering graphics subject. Okay, now let me show you. Now let me go to the desktop. Let me clear the annotations actually, right? Now first we'll see about a topic on the engineering graphics. We developed a software combining with this hardware so that you can effectively use this hardware and software tool to teach the subjects. So this is about the drawing the isometric view of a rectangular prism of base side 40 to 20 and height 60 mm. Also draw the isometric view of a rectangular pyramid of the same base size and axis height. If you want to hear the voice, just press the thing. Let me switch on the voice actually. So now
to draw the isometric view of the rectangular prism and pyramid.
Okay, go to the next step. So
as per the isometric principle, draw two 30 degree lines and on it set the width and breadth of the prism and pyramid. Set now, 20 mm and 40 mm respectively.
Now let me switch off this particular the setup so that you can get the images from our hardware com software setup. I'm a teacher, I will give the voiceover actually, right? So this is the first step for this particular problem, the second step, third step, fourth step, sixth step, and so on, so on and so forth. Suppose if a student has got any doubt, you can go back and forth. Okay, so this is how you can use this hardware and software tool that we developed especially exclusively developed for teaching the engineering graphic subject or in general the engineering subjects. The next problem is so and so, so and so. For that, this is the first step, second step, third step, fourth step, fifth step, like that it goes on. So the final step is this one. Okay, suppose if the student has got any doubt, you can go back and forth. So you can I think now itself you would have got an idea about how best you can use this hardware and software setup for teaching, especially for this subject, the engineering graphics subject. Okay, I'll exit this one. Okay, now as I said, the teaching engineering graphics subject is over. Let us see about teaching mathematics subject. Okay, I will double click this one. So for that, let us see about the explanation about the matrix addition. Okay, so suppose you as a teacher, so you can use these annotation tools. You can highlight something, you can write something, you can draw the matrix. Actually, you can write the matrices. Anything you want, you can do it. Okay, so we'll see the steps. Okay, so this is the next step. The two matrices can be added if they have the same order. That is n by n or m by n, right? So let us say A is a 3 by 3 matrix and B is a 3 by 3 matrix. Okay, so as I said earlier, we go to annotations. Suppose if you want to use a different color, you can use different color. Okay, let me clear this one. The next step, so sum of A plus B, sum of A plus B is this one. Okay, so like that it goes, like that goes actually. So these are some of the properties about the matrix addition actually. So if you want, you can see the next problem actually. So this is about the explanation about the SP symmetric matrix. First step, second step, third step, fourth step, fifth step, and so on. Suppose if you have any doubt, you can go back and forth. As I said earlier, you can do whatever annotations you want. Okay. Here the speed matrix is so and so, like that. Whatever things you like, you can write something. Okay, I'll exit this one. Okay, now engineering graphics is over, mathematics is over. Now let us see about the engineering physics. Okay, engineering physics. So this is about the software that we developed for the engineering physics subject actually. We have developed these softwares exclusively for to suit this hardware. So this is about a topic under physics, the acoustics and ultrasonics. So you can go in step by step actually. Okay, so the next problem maybe, or the next problem. Okay, so the duration of standard evaporation time. So this is the explanation about that particular topic in physics. Okay, I'll exit this one. Okay, now, so again I repeat, the engineering graphics over, maths over, physics over. Now we see about the chemistry now. So let us take one topic in chemistry actually. So this is the unit 4 of engineering chemistry as per the unionized syllabus. There is about the phase rules analyze. So in that, the definition about the phase rule. So if you want to highlight, you can highlight something. If you want to write something, you can write something. So like that it goes. As I said earlier, suppose if you can use this software come hardware tool for teaching all the subjects, even this engineering chemistry, right? Suppose if the students has got any doubt, you can go back and forth. Okay, so now I, with your permission, let me exit this one because we have to move to the other one. So let us see about the fundamentals of computing now. Okay, fundamentals of computing. Arrays. So the need of array, introduction about array, the contents you have here actually. So searching lecture objectives, then matrix operations. In that we are going to, you will be going to see about the various types of matrix operations like matrix addition, matrix subtraction, matrix multiplication, etc. etc. Okay. So this is about a sample demo on the fundamental psychometry subject. Then we'll see about the PPT demo now. Okay, we'll see about the PPT demo now. Okay. For a change, I have taken the medical subject, subject in MBBS, the human body systems. I have taken up that PPT file actually. So here, so you can see all these things actually. Suppose say if you have to zoom in, just double click it. You can pan. You can explain. Still further. Okay. Suppose if you want to explain more about this particular thing, you can just zoom in. Okay, you can just zoom in, and you can explain about the each and every part of this particular the part of the body. Okay. So like that it goes. Okay. The PSK. So let me close this one. PPT demo is over. The CAD model demonstration we'll see. The CAD model demonstration is available here. So you see, this is the IC engine assembly that we developed especially for the mechanical engineering students. You can just rotate it. You can zoom it, you can zoom out, you can zoom in. Then you can rotate it. So these are all possible here actually. So I opened another file here actually. So it's a four board mechanism. By pressing this one, you can rotate the object. You can rotate the object. So like this, you can make use of the this hardware setup using the software tools for teaching the not only the subjects, also the other softwares like CAD, CAM, other softwares actually, right? Now, let us see about the other one. The CAD model is over now. The different images demonstration, right? Different images, I kept it here actually. So this is the image of a programmable logic controller having 8 outputs and 6 8 inputs and 6 outputs actually. So these are the 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 relays, and these are the 8 inputs. You can view 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Okay, so you can zoom in, you can pan, everything you can do, your thing you can do. The next slide, this is about Arduino Nano chip. Okay, you can zoom in, pan it. So these are the digital pins the Arduino Nano has, and these are the analog pins the Arduino Nano has. Here you have to give the power supply and the reset button. You can use this pin as the reset button. Okay, this is the master reset for rebooting the program. So using RX and TX, you can transmit and receive the signals from and to other devices. So this is about the motherboard, the different component of a motherboard. So you can zoom in, you can pan, what you can do whatever you want. Okay, now this is about electrical motor. Again, as I said earlier, zoom it, pan it, zoom it and pan it, so that you can more easily explain about the different components, whether it is civil or mechanical or electrical or electronics or computer, everything you explain. So this is about the cut section of a heart. So you can zoom in. So this is about the lathe. The different parts of the lathe you can explain. Then this is about your milling machine. Okay, so like that you can explain about each and everything. So you can show the pictures of some mathematical points. This is about a palindrome, the Python image. Okay, so like that you can use this hardware tool not only for demonstrating about playing the video today, the teaching content, also the CAD content. Now I just showed you about the how best you can use the images for teaching the different topics. So now we see about the different animated things that we have as collection, right? If you open this application, here, open, okay, rib cage, the human rib cage actually, okay, you can rotate. You can zoom in, you can zoom in, you can zoom out, we'll see the next one. So this is about the eye, the full skeleton. You can zoom in, you can pan. This is about the lathe in 3D. This is about a dog. I'll show you one interesting component. So this is a hummingbird flying actually. So you can see the heart beating actually. Zoom out. So like that you can use these tools for explain about different topics, right? Then finally we'll see about the sample software application on the engineering graphics subject exclusively developed for our students. So the inputs is just type it, our software will play the answer instant based on. Starting from drawing the XLA. The next step is marking one end, 10 above, 20 in front. Then preliminary front view, completing the preliminary front view, preliminary top view, completing the preliminary top view, and drawing the arcs this side and completing the finally getting the final top view. Okay, so this is about the software that we developed exclusively for the engineering subject. Now, I said, I'll be in this demonstration, I'll be explaining about this 50-inch interactive digital display, the hardware that we used for explaining about the desktop annotation, teaching different subjects like engineering graphics, mathematics, engineering physics, chemistry, fundamental computing. So these are the software that we have developed e-learning content for other subjects also, but in this demonstration, I demonstrated only for these five subjects. Okay, and I gave a demonstration on PPT, CAD softwares we can use it for teaching, different images you can use it for teaching the different subjects, different animated things demonstration, and finally a sample software developed for a subject, the engineering graphics subject. I thank you all for watching this particular video. I hope this kind of hardware and software tool will be really useful for teaching learning process, especially teaching in an innovative and advanced way.